Mini chapter 93. Jaymi proposes the repurposing to Herb. Reclining on his bedroom terrace in the house on Electra Drive next day, Jaymi returns to the question of how to target Bangdead, and the fog on the far side of that question starts tunneling away down avenues of possible action into exhilarating focus. Throughout Evelyn's and Amber's noir caper at the South Central Motels, it didn't occur to Jaymi to set up much collaboration between them, though they did manage to snatch success from the jaws of chaos by a dint of sheer quirky bravado, plus a twist of inspired lunacy involving a pig's ribcage and a bunch of corpses stolen from funeral parlours. In Shigem's and Kim's and Evelyn's downtown LA caper, Jaymi did facilitate those beasts' discussions of what they were doing, through his landing them beside a welcoming café full of chatter. This marked a step upwards in his development as an orchestrator of incarnated beasts. Within the results, however, there was still an echo of the clatter of juxtaposed carnage that he'd first sensed at the Westmont motels. Yes, the street queens were spared that ugly crime against them, which was essential, but how oddly this sat with those KitKat and Krispy Kreme dramas, not to mention Evelyn's draping herself over retro-style cars at every opportunity. A further fine-tuning of his orchestrations is now due, perhaps. A finessed combination of melody and harmony will be brought to bear now that he's about to unleash a climactic noir caper. This one will be peopled by five incarnated beasts, and he's determined to encourage even more free and focused collaborations between them. This finesse, he should add, will be strictly at the service of the caper's goal, which is nothing less than to sabotage Bangdead's giant array of toxic news feeds while pointing the dreary ones towards other creative possibilities that perhaps they've never thought of trying. No pressure, then. After a moment's thought, he picks up his phone, touches a name, and listens while it rings. "Hey, Jaymi," answers Herb. "Hi, Herb, how are they hanging?" "They're hanging fine, I think. I could switch on video phone and take my pants down and we could both check, if you like." "No, that's fine, I'll take it on trust. Great work on the hack of Scorpio. I assume Dud was taken in?" "Yes, totally. That new beast is just the fiercest. Is he recovered now?" "Oh, he's peachy fine again now, thank you. His maker is a little battered by the experience, but hey, I can take it. Look, I have a proposal for you. It's taken shape in my head at last. It seems obvious in retrospect, but it's taken this long to get it straight because, well, it's also kind of complex, you see. It's technical stuff about ain't they freaky, by the way." "Right, okay, I was beginning to wonder whether maybe the video phone and pants down thing was still applicable after all." "Here's my plan," says Jaymi. "Inside Ain't They Freaky, we add a landscape like the version of downtown LA you built, but a version of the west side of LA instead. I'm thinking of the area from LAX, including where the server farm is, down as far as the El Segundo refinery. Straightforward enough, yes?" "Sure. You start with a framework from a 3D map, basically, then you model the art onto it and you apply whatever effects you want." "Okay, good. Next, I want us to take the content of the six news feeds, then break all of it down digitally and sort it into its raw constituent elements. I mean, each different letter, each number, and so on. We need a script that takes a snapshot of the news feeds, then pulls out all the constituents from the snapshot and sorts them into raw categories, letters and figures and symbols, plus pixels of red and green and blue bits. Am I making sense?" "You are," says Herb. "And they're still hanging great, by the way. Carry on, I'm intrigued now." "Okay, so here's a question for you. Within that brand new West Side landscape, could those salvaged raw constituents be stored inside the storage tanks in the refinery? Could a player be shown the news feeds being diverted into the different tanks, in effect?" Yeah, why not? That would be a cool display, sure." "And then, could those raw constituents inside those tanks be assembled and combined into something else within that West Side landscape?" "No reason why not. Those glyphs and pixels would just be raw data components that you could recombine however you like." "But here's a crucial question for you," says Jaymi. "After you recombine them, would they be the same glyphs and pixels that used to constitute the substance of the six news feeds before they were all cut out of those news feeds and moved into the tanks instead?" Herb laughs. "That is kind of a kooky artistic way of looking at it, Jaymi, I have to say. But yes, the glyphs and pixels would be the same ones if you were moving them into the new thing rather than just copying them into it. From the tanks, each glyph or pixel could be moved into any other piece of code of any length or complexity within that landscape. And sure, this moving could be clearly displayed at whatever speed you wanted to show it happening. Is this some fancy new game you want me to build? It sounds like fun, but I should warn you, I'll be invoicing my usual rates. Fine. Are you free to come to my place at 8:30 tomorrow evening, after dinner time, for drinks? I've invited Ashley, too. By the way, are you aware that she's come over to join us here on the dark side? Ashley Tweak? No way! No, I didn't know that. Wow! Sure, it'll be great to come over tomorrow, thanks. Ashley will be just as surprised to hear you've come over to us. I'm going to call her in a minute and compare notes. Good. Let's keep it between us three, of course. You bet. All right, I'll see you at your place at 8:30 tomorrow evening.